What's happening, folks? I'm back with another reaction, back with some more Duran Duran, and we're going to listen to some more live Duran Duran, going back to the 2011 A Diamond in the Mine album. Very much enjoying going through this, not only because it has several tracks from the fantastic All You Need Is Now album, but also some older tracks as well, and there's some more of those coming, but yeah, the next few... Oh wait, no, I'm wrong. I was going to say, I thought it was Blame the Machines and then Girl Panic. But it's Blame the Machines, The Reflex, and then Girl Panic. So two of the next three are from All You Need Is Now. I really do enjoy Blame the Machines, having heard it, you know, several more times since doing the reaction. I do appreciate the cheekiness of the lyrics a little bit more, in the sense that, you know, the idea of losing control of our lives because of the sort of offloading of tasks and responsibilities and activities to AI or to computers, really, to software, essentially. The idea of, like, well, I'm going left right now in my car because this machine is telling me to go left. And obviously, you know, these machines that we entrust to take us to places and to, you know, calculate things for our health and to make sure we don't miss appointments and so on, clearly, you know, there's no way that, you know, they could be unreliable or that they could be corrupted or hacked or whatever. So clearly I need to go left here because this machine is telling me to go left. Oh, wait, it wasn't the right place? Like, I'm not, like, what the hell? Well, I blame the machines because, you know, I can't take responsibility for... you know, making sure that I go through life and discerning between accurate information and otherwise. I just do what the machines tell me to do, because that's what we do in the modern era. We basically, you know, set all of our devices and we synchronize everything and we ultimately, you know, set all of our appointments and so on. And then when our machines beep and, you know, tell us that something is happening, well, clearly that means something is happening. So I like the playfulness of the song when it comes to the concepts of responsibility and accountability, but also technology and sort of the ubiquity and the pervasive nature of technology in not only, you know, modern society in public, but also like every little facet of our lives, more or less. So I know some people have talked to me, I'm forgetting, I think Izzy and some other people have mentioned that, like, Nick Rhodes, you know, has some ideas when it comes to some of these things. So maybe this is a song that he was involved in, or maybe it's Simon, I'm not sure. I'm sure someone told me when I reacted to the original. But yeah, I know that, you know, there's been a few times recently where I've thought about it, you know, strictly as, you know, Simon writes almost all of their lyrics, so this must be his. And there's been a couple times where people, like, I think, you know, Girl Panic was another example. Where someone said, you know, I think Nick might have had a hand in writing this one just because, you know, he's gotten at that issue before. So I don't know which one of them wrote it, but, or, you know, perhaps it was a collaboration. But either way, I really do enjoy the nature of the lyrics the more I've heard it. And, you know, specifically the example used is, like, he's driving on the Autobahn and it's like, you know, the machine is telling him to turn left, and, like, this idea that, well, I'm going to do that because, you know, obviously this is, you know, well-programmed and it's connected to satellites and they're up there observing everything and, you know, we're all part of this, like, techno-electrical system now, so obviously I need to do what the machine tells me, and then if it doesn't work out, well, I blame the machines because, you know, I trusted them. I put my, you know, reputation on the line for all these devices and so on. So, again, I really do enjoy the cheeky nature of the lyrics. Be interested to hear how it sounds live. I very much enjoy the sonics of the original. I mean, I don't think there's a single tune on All You Need Is Now that I don't really like. It's just a fantastic album, so I'm excited, as I said, to hear a couple of the tunes from that album in this live context. Although I'm looking at the soundtrack, I think after Girl Panic, that is the only remaining one, because, like, Ordinary World, Notorious, Wild Boys, Rio, so there's a lot of classics coming, but yeah, I think, you know, about halfway through the album, it switches more to the older catalog, but let's get it. This is Blame the Machines by Duran Duran on their 2011 album All You Need Is Now.
There are
Her voice was like it. Love that really high key melody. Bought into the dream. Really fast synth layer in there, I love it. Cavernous, echoic feel. Yeah, just offload all of your cognitive and processes and responsibilities to the machine. Because then, you know, you can evade any responsibility for misfortunes in your life. Ugh. The supporting back. And right at the end here, the bass is standing out. Fantastic. I really enjoy the performance. I think that, you know, it sounded pretty close to the album version. I'm always, when I listen to their live material in the last like month or so, you know, first Arena and now this, I'm constantly, and also the hilarious mistaken intro, but yeah, to the Make Me Smile, that was also a live tune, which I didn't realize going into it. But now I'm like hyper alert for like, oh, did they add anything? Is there an extra, you know, backing vocal and so on? But that sounded pretty close to the album version. Yeah, I really do enjoy it. And again, I think musically, I can hear the sort of like the throwback, the sort of like recapturing of the magic of the Rio album in a song like that. But I still think, you know, again, it sounds fantastic whether or not you know that connection. I'll keep saying it, but I really do think this album is great, both in terms of sort of, you know, carrying on that legacy in, you know, three decades later, but also just in terms of being a brilliant album of, like, you know, engaging pop music. So, yeah, shout out to this song, shout out to the lyrics as well. As I said, I really do enjoy them. And yeah, I wasn't able to get work off. So this coming weekend, I know they're playing up in Pasadena. I'm not gonna be able to see them. I know they're playing in Vegas like a month later, so I'm gonna see if I can make that work. It'll be a bit more of a mission. I'm willing to do it if it can happen, but again, it's just really hard to get time off from my work because like we're very like thinly staffed for what they are. So basically, if I can make that happen, it'd be fantastic. Because what I was gonna say is, it's a real testament to their quality when they perform live, like how good they sound. And again, like even though I'm constantly listening for new elements that might not have been in the studio version, the fidelity of the like actual, you know, song parts to the recorded studio version is always excellent. So once again, shout out to them. Let me know what you think of this one. Other than that, I will see you next time. Peace.